Okay, so good evening, everybody. I'm Atsushi Noguchi from Kanazawa University in Japan. So I'm really honored to be invited as a lecturer for Arkeo Hour International Lecture Series. So I'm really appreciate for ANURA, and I am very happy that we can still keep our relationship, friendship, even in this difficult pandemic condition. So I'm really sorry that I couldn't come to Sri Lanka for delivering my lecture in front of you. So instead, here I will talk. I will give my lecture from Japan. So actually here we are in the winter. So it is somehow strange. So I'm talking in a cold climate. So temperature in here is less than 5 degrees now. So I think Sri Lankan people are in different, quite different conditions. So anyway, so today, so first I was asked to talk about any subjects related to South Asian archaeology, but so I select another my subject on 3D documentation, application of 3D documentation in archaeology and cultural heritage management. So this is one of my most focusing topics for these years. So I'm very happy to give my lecture to you today. So before moving to the main section of today's talk, so I should give some detailed profile of myself. So I am an archaeologist. So basically, I'm studying in prehistory, especially Paleolithic in South Asia, Arabia, and Japan. So I have experiences of fieldwork in Japan, Pakistan, Oman, Iran, and Uzbekistan. So currently I am a visiting researcher of Center for Studies of Ancient Civilization and Cultural Resources in Kanazawa Universities. So I'm teaching some classes in civil universities on inter-civilization or GIS related subject. And so related to today's talk, so since 2012, so I have introduced 3D technology to archaeological studies and cultural heritage management. So I have experiences on various objects from small stone tools to large tombs and architectures. And meantime, I have organized or I have joined to the workshop in Pakistan. And for these years, I have also organized some workshops, international workshops online for Asian and Central American countries. So actually, in the last 2 weeks ago, so I gave 1 week lecture series for Central American countries. So today's my talk is a compilation of such a workshop and lectures. Okay, so at the beginning, I would like to give you a very basic knowledge on 3D documentation of cultural heritage. I think many of you are already familiar with the documentation of archaeology and cultural heritage. So, but also I would like to give you the very, very fundamental things. So what is the 3D documentation in cultural heritage management? So it is, in my sense, it is recording object as its original three-dimensional form based on point cloud. So point cloud means dense and tremendous number of measured points on the surface of object. So in case of this head of Buddha, made of stucco from Karawan site in Takeshita. So on this 3D documentation, I have obtained about 3 million of points with the 3D photogrammetry documentation. So this is exact entity of 3D documentation of updated 3D documentation of archaeology and cultural heritage. And so I should notice you that 3D documentation of archaeology and cultural heritage must be recording of object as its original three-dimensional form. So it is different from 3D modeling or computer graphics with construction by total or partial creation. So often we make confusion between such creative 3D models and documentation, but in scientific or academic point of view, we must distinguish 3D models with the creative 3D models and 3D documentation. And so how to measure and record shape information in 3D is very simple. So just need to add an additional dimension to ordinary two-dimensional documentations. So for long time, we record things in 2D forms on paper. So just we need to add additional axes. So we recorded X and Y axes. So now we should add Z axes. However, it is easy to say, but doing difficult to do. So because in 2D documentation, always one dimension is fixed as a reference plane. So for example, it is a paper. However, in 3D documentation, all dimensions are not fixed. All dimensions are in totally free conditions. So we, without references points in three axes, everything cannot be stable in this three-dimensional space. So we should set reference points and to for control rotation. And so here, so for long time, we human beings attempted to fix 3D object into two-dimensional space. So first method is also graphic projection. So fixing three-dimensional form in on a reference plane. So often we use grid for records actual place or coordinates of points. And so we still use this for instance, drawing pottery or recording structures in the excavation field. And also we develop mathematics, especially in geometry, for improving survey techniques. So it has also very long history since ancient civilization, and basic principle of geometry is of course same as ancient age. So we use the same triangulation principle for flat plate surveying or any other field documentation. And also graphic projection is also applied for drawings of small portable objects. So we apply the similar method from mechanical drawings or architectural drafting. Meantime, development of optics and cameras, which are attempting to capture a scene as of the image what we see through our naked eyes. So this optics and camera technology is relatively later than also graphic projection and geometry. And so it is somehow complicated techniques rather than drawings. But so we can, for instance, transform the lens distortion for creating accurate also graphic images. So these are also applied for documentation of cultural heritage. So photography is the best way for documenting subjecting objectivity with objectivity and reality. So, and development of optics optics delivers high resolution recordings for us. So capturing image by optical equipment is another important technology and method in cultural heritage documentation. So also we employ the plan geometry and survey techniques for documenting the plan drawings with a triangulation survey in field. And in addition, so we use estampage or laptop copy for replicating log inscription. So we have employed these methods and equip technologies for documenting our cultural heritage. But all these are in 2D, two-dimensional form due to the limitation of the media and measurement equipment. And so recently, we have rapid development of electronic or digital equipment. However, despite of development in both imaging and surveying technology, especially in terms of accuracy and resolution, recording media, which keep data through processing and publishing eventually, are still in 2D format. So either on traditional paper or in updated digital equipment, for instance, the displays, so which you see right now. So limitation of media is conditioning storage or archive and output forms. So 3D data must be reduced and finally lost one dimension during data processing in irreversible way. So once we could obtain 3D coordinates through processing and publication of our data, so we should reduce one dimension for fixing our result on paper or display in 2D form. So that is our issue. So actually, a 3D measurement has already been installed in archaeology and cultural heritage management. So we frequently use electronic distance meter or total station surveying system. So actually, total station acquires the 3D coordinates of single point in one time. So however, due to limitation of media in storage and publication, so always we should reduce one dimension. So, but so recent, most updated 3D documentation, 3D measurement is different from such conventional 3D, three-dimensional measurement with total station or other equipment. So today, so I will talk about this updated 3D documentation, which data is composed of dense point clouds equal to aggregation of measured points on the surface of object, so tremendous number of measured points on the surface. Okay, before talking about application, so we should give you a detail of nature and the form of 3D documentation data. So actually, a main body of modern updated 3D data is just a matrix of vertices or measured points in XYZ coordinates. So you can see the matrix of coordinates in left side of this slide. So this is all of 3D data, so just aggregation of numeric values as coordinates. And so within these values, we can record not only coordinates, but also normals, normal vectors or colors of each point, vertices, et cetera. And once we record the document, a tremendous number of points on the surface of object, then a computer vision technology, computer graphics technology creates a triangulated irregular network, so-called TIN. So this is the process segmenting out a point cloud with triangles by connecting closest points. So through this process, we obtain a so-called wireframe model represented in right side of this slide, which covers the surface of object with the triangles connecting with measured points. However, this wireframe doesn't have faces. So it is it is in see-through conditions. So in the next step, we should set, we should give faces with filling wireframe. Then we should calculate normals that is perpendicular vector from given face. So, and this normal is the base of lighting, reflecting, and shading on 3D models. So it is also called a surface model or shaded model as represented in the right side of this slide. So now you can recognize differences between wireframe model and surface model. So surface model has a shade or illumination, a reflection by a normals on each faces. And we can give, we can document colors by each measured point. Also, we can give colors to each meshes. And eventually we can give more high resoluted detailed colors by stitching full color photos onto mesh models. So we call this as texture models. So you can recognize how it is, how it has high resolution, how it is very clear. And so it is somehow complicated. 3D model has very complex form, but texture is created in 2D, two-dimensional images, as the same as photos. So this is an example that 3D documentation, 3D photogrammetry software cut out the surface, the texture of surface, texture on the surface of object, and made a mosaic for adjusting with three-dimensional coordinate transformed into 2D. So you can so you can recognize eyes and nose here. So this part is corresponding to this part in 2D form, and so on. Another top of head is appeared here, and this part is corresponding here. So this correspondence is managed by a computer software. And with normals, surface models, we can control lighting, light and illumination in virtual condition, under virtual conditions. So with development of computer graphics technology, so real-time rendering of illumination or shading is now available. So even on a small sized laptop computer. So as I mentioned in previous sections, 3D modeling has different meaning in the field of computer graphics and CAD, or computer-assisted drawings. So 3D modeling is a procedure which creates 3D objects with components of points, lines, curves, and polygons with full, it is all by full scratch creations. So in archaeology and heritage management, it is more important to manage major data on actual objects, archaeological artifacts or heritage, monumental buildings. So in archaeology and cultural heritage management, we should do measurement, processing, then modeling, rather than direct modeling by creations. So always we must be aware with these differences between 3D documentation and 3D modeling. And here I would like to show you advantage of 3D data. So first advantage is we can create a perfect orthographic projection from any directions. So once you get full 3D data, so you don't need to measure objects from different directions. So we can get measurement values and orthographic projection from in any direction, from different any directions in from one single documentation. Also, we can control of field of view. So this is absolutely impossible with ordinary conventional documentation. So we can change a field of view as you like in virtual. So in archaeology and cultural heritage management, we usually use orthographic projection only, but sometimes in field of architecture, we should create a perspective views. So just giving some parameter, we can transform our 3D model into perspective conditions easily. And in addition, we can obtain more measurement values, such as profile, angles, areas, volumes. So wherever we have point, measured point as a point cloud, so we can extract any form of measurement from single models. So once we document an object, so we can get a measurement, we can create orthographic projections, so we can work with many various, we can do various work on single documentation. This is an advantage of 3D data. So well, now I think you are interested with actual application in archaeology and cultural heritage management field of 3D documentation. So I will introduce some of my and my colleagues' works. So first, this is the case of field documentation of dwelling pit in ancient age site in Japan. So in conventional or traditional documentation, so we measure and draw the outline of structures with some profile. So we added, for instance, a height. So, but in this conventional or traditional documentations, we measure only selected point. So This means that we can record very limited information from only from selected parts. On the contrary, updated 3D documentation with dense point cloud records entire surface of object. So it is non-selective. So all out entire region record. And from this updated modern data set, so what we can do is we can get coordinates from any point, any part. We can create, we can draw profiles in any part, in any direction. So we can retrieve additional information after documentation, even after left from the field, so we can do additional measurement in virtual on 3D models. And also we can apply image enhancement and other visualization technologies on our 3D data. So this is a case of Japanese ancient tool, so-called keyhole-shaped mound tool. So traditionally, we document this type of mound with contour plot as represented in the right side of this slide. But updated 3D documentation data covers entire surface. So we can evaluate slopes of mound in any place. So in the second light of this slide, so this represents a slope of mound. Reddish part is a relatively flat part, while bluish part represents slope inclined part. So here you we can easily recognize two stages, two flat part in different height. So it is better for understanding the shape and form of tombs or topography rather than a traditional contour plot. And of course, we can apply a similar visualization on built remains. So this is the case, the example of Italian ancient remains in Sardinia Island. So I got data from sketchfab.com, and so then applies color stepped visualization as represented in left side. So once we obtain this type of 3D data, then we can evaluate, for instance, the transformation and of remains through the time. And of course, we can apply image enhancement on small object. This is a case of medieval tombstone in Japan. So you can recognize more clear image in center of this slide. This is applied image enhancement on left original 3D model represented in there. Also, we can generate contour of surface of tombstone as represented in slide. Image enhancement technology techniques is also applicable on stone tools or potteries. So this is another case of Paleolithic stone tools in Japan. The original 3D model is represented in the, in light, lightest. And then I applied lighting shading control inverter. So I generate, I have generated shade models from different lighting condition from different direction and angles. Then eventually I create an overlap of different multiple shaded models as represented in the left most part of this slide. So now surface condition is more visible than original 3D models. And this is a case study of my colleagues in Tokyo National Research Institute for Cultural Property. So they have worked in Cambodia for a long time, and they applied 3D laser scanning for evaluating structural deformation for conservation works. So in light side, so reddish part represent the deformed part of original architecture. So with this documentation, so they can do more accurate conservation work for reconstructing this old ancient temple field. And some of you may remember this. This is Notre Dame Church in Paris, which was burnt down. So however, some researchers obtained 3D documentation data before burning down this church. So now French government work reconstruct this historic church with this 3D documentation. And this is another important application of 3D documentations for cultural heritage under sleep. So this is an achievement of Recreate project. So this statue of Lyon has completely demolished by a Daesh Islamic extremist. However, we can reconstruct three-dimensional form of demolished object with limited record of photos with 3D photograph method. Okay, so I should do more quickly. So next is a technologies applied on 3D documentation of archaeological and cultural heritage subject. So there are two major technologies, such as laser or LiDAR scanners and 3D photograph method. So major differences between laser scanner and 3D photograph method is laser scanner is direct measurement. So laser scanner can record absolute distance, orientation, and scale with reflection of laser beam, while 3D photogrammetry is indirect relative measurement with stereoscopy method. So laser scanner, principle of laser scanner, laser scanning is very simple. So just projecting the laser beam on the surface, onto the surface of object, then detecting the reflection. So with the measurement and calculation of angles of reflections, so laser scanner can reconstruct the distance from laser to object surface. And so laser scanner can obtain the millions of measurements within minutes. So now we can use portable small desktop laser scanners. And these are more high-end models. And this is one of development of my colleague. So this laser scanner can measure more than 100 pieces of stone tools in one time. So average scanning time is about 5 minutes per piece. So laser scanner is very good for automation or reduction of working time for all documentation. And there is another type of laser scanner, so-called middle range scanners. So these small type, small size scanners can measure within nanometer, so mainly between 30 centimeter to 1 meter, while this type of middle range scanner can measure from 1 meter to 100 to, or 200 meters distance. And so principle of middle range laser scanner is different from triangulation scanners. So there are two different types of measurement method, time of flight, measuring distance by reflection time, and phase shift, measuring distance by phase shift after reflection. And I should emphasize this, that now iPhone and iPad has laser LiDAR scanners. So behind, if you have iPhone 12 or 13 Pro, so you can find laser LiDAR sensor here, just below the camera lens. And so this is an example how iPhone documents lock inscription in Japan. So with small mobile phone, so you can record, document archaeological and cultural heritage object. Okay, so I should move to next. So 3D photogrammetry. Now I explain about the 3D photogrammetry. 3D photogrammetry is totally different from laser scanning. So 3D photogrammetry is based on stereoscopy techniques, which reconstructs relative distance with a pair of photos, so-called stereo pairs. So modern photogrammetry is based on SFM-MVS technology. SFM is structure from motion, which is matching key points on a series of photos and reconstructing camera positions. As represented in this slide. And multi-view stereo is reconstructing depth information from multiple stereo pair photos for building point cloud. So this is an example of pottery in Japan. So as represented in the light, 3D photogrammetry software identify multiple key points on the surface of object. So, and with connecting these key points, so software reconstructs 3D form eventually. And so how to get photos for 3D photogrammetry is almost the same as conventional, traditional photography, archaeological and cultural heritage photography. And so we can employ this type of automated timetable for reducing working time. And so this is the final result with automated turntables. Ideal photo set should be spherically covering object as represented on this slide. And in the field, so instead of spherically covering of object, so horizontal and parallel covering of the target area for flat area. So in this is same in aerial survey, for instance, using the drones, aerial vehicle, UAV. So sorry for too much quick explanation, but so now I should go to the last sections. So after obtaining the 3D documentation data, so we must publish our data, our result. And so currently there are two major trends in publication of 3D documentation. In academic or professional academic field or professional purpose, there is clear tendency to use more conservative and conventional ways rather than updated method. So in academic field, two-dimensional representation in printed material or equally PDF documents are still major. But for public outreach, more dynamic and interactive method is preferred rather than traditional ways. So such as virtual reality or augmented reality. So for academic purpose, especially research, archaeological research, accuracy and data availability means reproducibility and reusability is more important rather than good appearance and interactivity. So for the purpose, standardization and conventional representation is preferred. And reliability for long-term storage archives is also important for this purpose. So we apply similar representation, visualization in a traditional ways such as orthographic projection and profile drawings with measured values. But so nowadays we can use full color publication both in printed material and PDF documentation in on computer. So we can employ 2.5-dimensional representation, 2.5-dimensional representation. So in this drawing, thickness is represented in color or contour plot with traditional two-dimensional visualization. And we can also use 3D PDF, so we can embed our 3D model into a PDF document. But problem is 3D PDF data size, file size of 3D PDF increases about 10 times larger than ordinary PDF. So instead of direct embedding of 3D models onto PDF document, so we can share 3D data in supplementary data by online repositories. So this is currently most smart solution for sharing 3D data, I think. And movie or video is still also useful for sharing 3D data. So we can't obtain the for instance, measurement values from videos, movies, but we can get, how can I say, subjective impression of 3D forms of object. And now we can share a 3D model itself on online platform, so such as sketchfab.com. So sketchfab.com is currently the largest and major platform for publishing 3D models. So now many institutes and universities provide their own 3D models on this platforms. For instance, British Museum, so Metropolitan Museum, and any other, many other museums and institutes provide 3D data. So if you have time, so I recommend you to search sketchfab.com, for instance, keyword with Sri Lanka or Sri Lanka heritage, so you can find the series of 3D models on Sketchfab. Okay, so this is a concluding remark. So sorry for exceeding my time. So advantage of 3D documentation is free from limitation of output methods and media. So 3D, all 3D documentation is obtained as born digital data. So it can manage in cross-platform condition as virtual digital data. And 3D documentation can acquire large scale data in one time within shorter time than traditional conventional method. And with a laser scanner or other updated technologies, we can automate our working procedures. So as far as a measurement device or software application covered such functions. And we can share our data across different platforms. For instance, we can share our data between different operation systems from Windows to Mac OS or Linux. And we can process 3D data on different softwares. And most important character of 3D documentation is we can duplicate our data in a lossless way. So we can easily make copies, accurate copies and of our data. So it would be very good backup for our data. So once we lost actual object and natural disaster or some, for instance, a warfare, so we can keep our data in digital form, and we can reconstruct our archaeological and cultural heritage object through this data. So these are advantages of 3D data. However, still there are limitations. First limitation is output method and media. Now we are under global shifting to online web-based publication from traditional printed material-based publication. So this issue will solve soon later, I think. And another problem, another issue is the limitation of large data handling. So actually, the data size of 3D documentation is larger than traditional conventional documentations. So large data requires more calculating resource for transformation and rendering. However, every year we see rapid development of information technology and the computer specification. So this issue will solve soon as well. So my last sentence is, if we need more details and more data, so we should choose 3D documentations. So my working counterpart, Tobun Ken, Tokyo National Research Institute for Cultural Properties, will host a one-day online workshop on 3D photogrammetry in next February or March. So soon later, we will call for participation. However, this workshop, because of our capacity, so we cannot prepare a seat for individual-based participation. So we will call to universities, institutes, those which are interested with our workshop. So if we are eager to join the workshop, please contact me through your university or institute. So just for your information, so in the last workshop, we had participants from Cambodia, Nepal, Pakistan, and Iran. So we, all of you are welcome to take part in our workshop. Okay, so my lecture is over. So thank you for your attention.